Jai Hind children, welcome in your maths live class. In today's class, we will start from question number 7 of exercise 15A. And by today only, we will complete this exercise. So, be ready with your notebook, pen and your maths book. Children, let's see the question. It is, one of the angles of a triangle is 100 degrees. And the other two angles are equal. Find each of the equal angles. There are three angles in a triangle, children. In a triangle, there are three angles. One of the measure is given. That is 100 degree. One angle measure is given to us. It is 100 degree. And the rest two angles is, they are equal. The rest two angles which is left in the triangle, they are equal. So, they are asking what is the value of those angles. So, quickly we will write the given part and also you draw the rough diagram. By drawing the rough diagram, you will able to see, you will able to recall what you have to do and how you have to solve it. So, let's see. I am doing the rough diagram. In this way, you just draw the rough diagram. Write down rough diagram. Okay, we are having a triangle, name is not given to us, and in the rough diagram without using ruler you can draw in this way, but if you are using the proper diagram, always use the ruler, children. You have to measure with, you have to draw this with the help of ruler, with the help of pencil. Now there are three angles. One of the angle is 100 degree. One of the angle is 100 degree. And the other two angles are equal. And we don't know what it is. So, let the first angle be x. The second one, if it is x, this is also equal to this angle. So, if it is equal to x, then it is also same as x. Now, we can find it now. So, we will write question number 7. Given one angle is 100 degree, other angles are equal. Other angles are equal. This is given part. So let one of the other angle be x. Let one of the other angle be x, then the third angle will also be equal to x. Then third angle, why it is equal, children? Because it is given in the question. It is given that the third angle will also be, then third angle will also be what? Will also be x. Okay, so you will summarize in this way, because nothing is given, only 100 degree is given. So we have chosen this as x, and the second one is also equal to the third one is also equal to the second one. So if the second angle is x, then the third angle will also be equal to x. Now using angle sum property of triangle, so we will rub this, children. I am going to erase the given part. Given part is already given in your question. So now using, we know what we know, children. Sum of the angles of all the triangle is equal to 180 degree. So 100 plus x is equal to 180 degree. Here you will write angle sum property of triangle. Clearly mention the reason why 100 plus x is equal to 180. Why you have written this? So, you have to write down the reason. Always, children, write down the reason. It will clear your concept also, and it will be a revision for you also. That why the sum of three angles is equal to 180 degree. Now, one angle is 100 and the other two are equal. If one is x, that another one will also be x. Okay? So, now we will solve this. 100 plus x, how many x are there? no coefficient means 1. So 1x plus 1x, how many x? 2x, that is equal to 180 degree. Okay, now keep 2x on this side, 180 is already on RHS side. We have to transpose this 100 to RHS. So 100, when it will transpose to this side, it will be subtracted there. So 2x is equal to 100, 180 minus 100 is 80, and x is equal to 40 degree. Hence other angle measure is how much? 40 degree. So you will write it also, because x we have chosen as x. What they are asking? They are asking what is the measure of other angles. So other angles measure is 40 degree. Clear? I think it is easy, isn't it? Now let's switch to the next question, children. Next question is, we have to go for the next question. Question number 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So out of these questions, I will solve all odd number questions. So my turn is for question number 9. Question number 9. And let's see the question 8. Question 8 is, children, each of two angles, no need to write, but just understand it because it is homework part. Each of the two angles of an isosceles triangle is twice the third angle. Find the angles of the triangle. Each of the two angles of an isosceles triangle. So if one is x, then the other two angles, and they are equal also, the other two angle is twice of it. ठीक है, एक एंगल x है, हमें नहीं पता क्या है, what is the measurement, all the three angles we don't know. So let take the value of x of that angle whose value we don't know, जिसकी value हमको पता ही नहीं है, उसको हम x लेंगे. ठीक है, so let it be x, and the other two angles are twice of it. So if one angle is x, the other two angles will be twice of x. Both are equal, children. Okay, in isosceles triangle, the base angles are also equal. This is the property. So two angles will be equal. Base angles are equal, children. So if one is x, the other two angles will be 2x. So 2x plus 2x plus x will be equal to 180 degree. So in this way, you can solve question number 8. And it is your homework part. I'm going to solve question number 9. So you quickly write down question number 9 and then we will start doing it. Okay. Quickly write down, children, question number 9. I am also erasing my board work. It is, if one angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of other two. One angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of other two. Show that the triangle is right angle triangle. You have to show it, children. Okay. So let's start solving it. Question is, one of the angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of other. Okay. So rough diagram is not given. Now it's visible, children. So we are having a triangle, okay, and we have to prove that it is a right angle triangle. We have to prove that, children, this is a right angle triangle. It is not mentioned that one of the angle is 90 degree, diya hi nahi hai, theek hai, but we have to prove it that it is a right angle triangle. What is given to us? It is, if it is A, B and C, so what is given to us? It is given to us that one of the angle, let's take it as this, one of the angle, this angle is equal to the sum of other two, is equal to the sum of other two. So if you will take given, what is given? One angle is equal to the sum of other two angles. Okay, so let's take one angle. I have chosen B here, na? So we can use B also. So let angle B is equal to the sum of other two angles. Let's pick any angle. I have picked angle B beta. आप कोई भी एक एंगल पिक कर लो एंड दैट एंगल इज इक्वल टू द सम ऑफ अदर टू एंगल्स. सो अदर टू एंगल्स आर व्हाट? एंगल ए प्लस एंगल सी. दिस इज एंगल ए प्लस एंगल सी. नाउ चिल्ड्रेन, व्हाट वी नो? वी नो दैट एंड ऑल द सम ऑफ ऑल थ्री एंगल्स इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. ठीक है, सो वी विल यूज दैट. नाउ ऑल्सो angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Why it is equal to 180 degree? Angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. यहाँ पे आप लिखेंगे angle sum property, angle sum property of triangle. Angle sum property of triangle. You will write it here. Okay, why it is equal to 180 degree? The sum of all three angles is equal to 180 degree. Now, children, if you will see from here, A plus C is equal to how much? It is equal to angle B. So, can we use A plus angle C? Can we write it side by side? Yes, we can write. It is a addition is always commutative. Aap 6 plus 7 plus 8 likho, or you can write it as 8 plus 7 plus 6. It is, the answer will always be same. Commutative. You can change its places, huh? If you are doing addition. So angle A plus angle C plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Kya main aise likh sakti hu? Can I write this? Yes, I can write this. Angle A plus angle B plus angle C, sum is 180. Yes, we can write. But why your ma'am has written it side by side? So that I can use what is given. What is given, children? Angle A plus angle C is given that it is equal to the third angle. आप कोई भी एंगल चूज कर सकते हो. मैम ने आपके एंगल बी चूज किया. एंगल बी इज इक्वल टू द सम ऑफ एंगल ए एंड एंगल सी बिकॉज इट इज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन की एक एंगल दूसरे दो एंगल के सम के बराबर है. सो अदर टू एंगल्स आर दिस एंड देयर सम इज दिस. So I am instead of writing A plus C, angle A plus angle C, I am writing it is same as angle B. Angle A plus angle C is same as angle B. So I can write it. दोनों equal है ना, तो चाहे मैं ये लिखूं चाहे मैं ये लिखूं. So A plus C की जगह मैम लिख रही है आपकी angle B. Angle B plus next one is angle B is equal to 180 degree. Angle B plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Till now it is clear? I think it is clear, children. You can write. Yes, ma'am, it is clear to us. Angle B plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. So now, next part. Angle B plus angle B. How many angle B, children? If you will write, I am going to write the same equation. Angle B plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. ठीक है, दिस इज दिस इक्वेशन आई हैव रिटन. सो हाउ मेनी एंगल बी चिल्ड्रेन? 1 + 1, 2 एंगल बी इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. ट्वाइस ऑफ एंगल बी इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. एंड नाउ एंगल बी इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. दिस टू इज इन मल्टीप्लीकेशन. दिस टू इज इन मल्टीप्लीकेशन. व्हेन इट विल ट्रांसपोज हेयर इट विल बी डिवाइडेड. ओके, सो एंगल बी इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच? Now angle B is equal to 90 degree. Hence we have proved that if the sum of two angles of a triangle is equal to the third angle of that triangle, then it is a right angle triangle. 90 degree aa gaya na, one of the angle is 90 degree, so it is a right angle triangle. Hence the given triangle is a right angle triangle, right angled triangle. In this way you have to write. ठीक है, यू कैन चूज एनी वन ऑफ द एंगल एज द सम ऑफ अदर टू एंगल्स. मैम ने आपके एंगल बी चूज किया. एंगल बी इज इक्वल टू एंगल ए प्लस एंगल सी, एंड एंगल ए प्लस एंगल सी की जगह एंगल बी लिख दिया. ठीक है, एंगल बी प्लस एंगल बी इज 180. ट्वाइस ऑफ एंगल बी इज 180. सो टू इट विल ट्रांसपोज हियर. एंगल बी शो हो गया कि इट इज 90 डिग्री. सो नाउ एंगल बी इज 90 डिग्री. इफ एंगल बी इज 90 डिग्री, इट मीन्स इट इज अ राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल. कोई भी एक एंगल, अगर तीनों एंगल में से कोई भी एक एंगल 90 डिग्री हो गया तो इट इज अ राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल. क्लियर? नाउ आई थिंक इट इज क्लियर. नाउ शिफ्ट टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 11. लेट्स सी क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 ऑल्सो दैट यू हैव टू सॉल्व इन योर ओके. इट इज डिफरेंट क्वेश्चन चिल्ड्रेन. सो कैन आई एक्सप्लेन इट? ओके, आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन इट. ओके, सो वॉट यू कैन डू, नो नीड टू राइट इट, जस्ट सी हेयर. ओके, सी द क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट. सी द क्वेश्चन चिल्ड्रेन. आई एम इरेजिंग माई बोर्ड वर्क. सो चिल्ड्रेन, आई एम इरेजिंग माई बोर्ड वर्क. मीन वाइल यू जस्ट रीड आउट द क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 इज फॉर होमवर्क, बट आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग. यू विल सॉल्व इट चिल्ड्रेन, बट आई विल एक्सप्लेन हाउ यू विल सॉल्व. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10, इट इज इन अ ट्राइंगल ए बी सी, इफ ट्वाइस ऑफ एंगल ए, इन अ ट्राइंगल ए बी सी, इन अ ट्राइंगल, वन ट्राइंगल इज गिवन चिल्ड्रेन ए बी सी, ट्वाइस ऑफ एंगल ए इज इक्वल टू थ्राइस ऑफ एंगल बी, that is equal to 6 times of angle C. Okay, this is the question. Twice of angle A is equal to 3 times angle B. 3 times angle B children, 3 times angle B, and that is equal to 6 times angle C. You have to find the value of A, B and C. Now children, quickly write down in the chat box. Today it is open. Quickly write down children that which angle is greater. Come on, which angle is the greatest one? Angle A, B or C, which angle is the greatest one? I am having a triangle, angle A, B and C. If we will twice it, whatever the measurement of this angle is, if we will make it twice, that will be equal to angle B, but not exactly angle B. When we will thrice it, okay, 3 times of angle B, and that is also equal to angle C, but not alone children. When we will, whatever the measure of angle C is, when we will make it 6 times. Yes, yes children, you are writing. Okay, so which one is the greatest one? Angle A is the greatest one. Okay, angle A को सिर्फ 2 times करने पर ही वो उसके बराबर आ जा रहे हैं. If you will make it 3 times, then it will be equal to angle A and angle C. And angle C, when you will make it 6 times बड़ा करोगे, then it will be equal to the other 2 angles. So now, what is the measurement of each angle they have asked? We don't know. Nothing we know that angle A, angle B and angle C measurement is what? Measure is what? So, we don't know its value. Okay? Angle A kitna hai, angle B kitna hai, we don't know. But we know this relation that if we will make it twice, if it will make it thrice and if we will make it 6 times, then all will be equal. Kisi ek value ke barabar honge. That will be equal to one value. Okay? Maybe it is 80 degree, maybe it is 90 degree, maybe it is 110 degree, we don't know. So let that value be x. Let the value which is equal to all this is x. Okay, so we will write it at, let the equal value of all these is x. It means twice of angle A is equal to x, thrice of angle B is also equal to x, and 6 times of angle C is also equal to x. Because these three are equal. So if it is equal, then what is the value? It is not given. Let's take it as x. Isko x le lete hain ki maan lo ये जो भी वैल्यूज हैं और आपस में इक्वल हैं, दैट दे आर इक्वल टू एक्स. नाउ फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन डिराइव व्हाट इज एंगल ए. सो फ्रॉम हेयर एंगल ए, चिल्ड्रेन ट्वाइस ऑफ एंगल ए इज एक्स. इसको मत देखो, नो नीड टू सी इट. ट्वाइस ऑफ एंगल ए इज इक्वल टू एक्स. सो एंगल ए इज इक्वल टू एक्स बाई टू. एंगल ए इज इक्वल टू एक्स बाई टू. कैन वी राइट? यस वी कैन राइट. ओके, दैट फ्रॉम यूजिंग दिस इक्वेशन वी कैन राइट दैट एंगल ए इज इक्वल टू एक्स बाई टू. एंगल ए टू को उधर ले जाइए बेटा, शिफ्ट टू टू दैट साइड. सो वेन टू इज शिफ्टेड टू दिस साइड, एंगल ए इज इक्वल टू एक्स बाई टू. सेम हेयर, एंगल बी इज इक्वल टू थ्री विल गो टू दैट साइड. सो एंगल बी इज इक्वल टू एक्स बाई थ्री. ओके, एंड द थर्ड वन एंगल सी इज इक्वल टू एक्स बाई सिक्स. एंगल सी किसके बराबर है? एंगल सी इज इक्वल टू एक्स बाई सिक्स. एक्स कहां से आया? एक्स वी हैव चूजन दैट दिस इज इक्वल टू दिस इक्वल टू दिस. ऑल आर इक्वल टू सम वैल्यू. ए किसी वैल्यू के बराबर है. जब एंगल ए को ट्वाइस करेंगे, एंगल थ्री को बी को थ्राइस करेंगे, इसको सिक्स टाइम्स करेंगे, तो वो किसी एक वैल्यू के बराबर है. एंड ऑल आर इक्वल. सो वॉट इज दैट वैल्यू? लेट इट बी एक्स. सबके बराबर है वो एक्स एक्स एक्स. ठीक है. सो फ्रॉम हेयर एंगल ए इज इक्वल टू एक्स. नाउ वॉट यू विल डू चिल्ड्रेन? एंगल ए प्लस एंगल बी प्लस एंगल सी इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच? इट इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. इट इज अ ट्राइंगल. सो वी विल यूज एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी. सो क्विकली वॉट यू कैन राइट? एंगल ए प्लस एंगल बी प्लस एंगल सी इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. ये आप लिखेंगे. एंड नाउ चूज एंगल ए. वॉट इज एंगल ए? एक्स बाई टू. पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ एंगल ए, एक्स बाई टू. एंगल बी, एंगल बी क्या है बेटा? एक्स बाई थ्री. एंड एंगल सी इज एक्स बाई सिक्स. एंड दैट ऑल आर इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. And in this way, you can solve the value of x. आप क्या निकालेंगे? The value of x. How? 2, 3 and 6. LCM will be 6. Okay, multiply 6 on both side and solve it. Linear equation में हमने किया है ये. Solve this and then find the value of x. Okay, find the value of x. Once you will get the value of x from that equation, put it in angle A, angle B and angle C. Then you will get the exact value of angle A, B and C. So in this way you have to solve it. Children, solve it by your own. It's very interesting, children. And you feel very happy after solving this. Now let's see the next question. Question number 11 we have to solve. So I am erasing my board work and you write question number 11 in your classwork notebook. Now children, see question number 11. What is the measure of each angle of an equilateral triangle? What is the measure of each angles of an equilateral triangle? Now children, equilateral triangles are those triangles in which all sides as well as angles are equal, children. Okay, we have learned about the triangles. We have classified the triangles according to its side and according to its angles. Okay, so in question number 11 it is asking that what is the measure of each angles of an equilateral triangle. There is an equilateral triangle children. Okay, equilateral triangle means the sides are equal. If it is 5 centimeter, this will also be 5 centimeter and this one will also be 5 centimeter. All the sides were equal in an equilateral triangle. As well as its one of the property is that if the sides of a triangle are equal, it is an equilateral triangle and its angles are also equal. So if this is x, this will also be x and this one will also be x. They are asking, the question is asking that what is the measure of this angle? So let's solve this. Okay. So you will write it as a rough diagram. Just write down this as a rough diagram. Okay. Because I have drawn it as a rough diagram. So it's a rough diagram, children, to understand the concept of equilateral triangle. So now let one of the angle of an equilateral triangle is x. Let one of the angle of an equilateral triangle is x, then the other two angles will also be equal to x. Then the other two angles will also be equal to x. If one is x, second one is also x, and the third angle will also be equal to x. Now we will solve this, children. How we will solve? Just let me erase this diagram. And now we know that the sum of all the angles will be equal to 180 degree. The sum of all the angles will be equal to 180 degree. X plus X plus X is equal to 180 degree. Here you will write angle sum property of triangle. Angle sum property of triangle. Okay. So X plus X plus X. How many X? 3X. 3X is equal to 180 degree. 3x is equal to 180 degree, and x is equal to 180 by 3, that is x is equal to 60 degree. X is equal to 60 degree, children. This will be our answer. Okay, this will be our answer. Okay, hence the measure of each angles of an equilateral triangle is 60 degree. After this you will write it. Hence, the measure of each of the angle of an equilateral triangle will be, hence, the measure of the angles of an equilateral triangle will be, how much? Will be 60 degree, children. Will be 60 degree. So, in this way, we will solve this question. Now, one more question is left, and after that you can see the questions 13, 14 and 15. It is in the form of true, false, fill in the blank. So this you will solve in the book only. Like, can a triangle have two right angles? No. So write down no by using pencil. Two obtuse angles? No. Two acute angles? Can a triangle have two acute angles? Yes, it can. It can have three acute angles also. And all angles more than 60 degree? All angles should not be equal to, not be equal to 60, but not more than 60. All angles less than 60 degree, it is also not. One of the angle will be less than 60 and the other should be more than 60. It should be a mixture. All angles are equal to 60? Yes. So use pencil and write down the answer. I am going to solve question number 12. As an explanation, children. So quickly, I am erasing my board, and you just see question number 12. Draw this diagram, question number 12 diagram, in your rough notebook, because it is your homework question. So I will only explain it, and you people will solve it. Okay, children, quickly see question number 12. In the given figure, DE is parallel to BC. In the given figure, see the diagram. I have drawn it for you. It is question number 12. So, in the given figure, DE is parallel to BC. DE is parallel to BC. And angle A is 65, angle B is 55 degree. They are asking some angles measure from us. The angles are angle ADE, angle ADE means this one. What is the measurement of this angle? Okay, this they are asking first. Then what is the measure of angle AED and angle C? Angle AED, this one, children. Okay, and angle C, this one. So they are asking three angles measure from us. They have given only two and they are asking that what is angle this, this and this. So children, we will apply our previous knowledge concept that if the lines are parallel, draw it children, D, E and BC. So if it is BC and it is DE, I have picked these two lines from this triangle. Okay, BC is not parallel right now. I think now it is parallel. Yes, it a little bit is parallel. So now if BC is parallel to DE, so this line which is intersecting it here at B and at D, this is the transversal line children. Extend it children, extend it, extend all the three lines. Okay, extend all the three lines, this is B. So what is it? I have extended this line, BC line and DE line. DE line ko ma'am ne yahan badha diya, BC ko bhi thoda aur badha diya, dotted line se, because it is not the line which is given to us. We have extended it and this line till here. Now can you see that this is a transversal line? Yes, of course. If these two are parallel line and it is intersecting it, this line is intersecting it as two distinct points. So this is the transversal line. This will be the transversal line. So whatever angle be this, this is 55 degree na? This is 55 degree. So same will be this angle. Same will be this angle children. This is also equal to 55 degree. What is the reason? Reason is corresponding angles. Ye kya hai? Corresponding angles hai. If the lines are parallel and on one side of transversal line and at one part, CK, BC ke ek part pe idhar hai aur DE ke upper part pe hai. These two angles will be corresponding angle, and if the lines are parallel, yes they are parallel. It is given in the question that they are parallel. So they both will be equal. Corresponding angle tab equal bhi ho jayenge agar lines parallel hongi. So by using this property, by using the transversal line in transversal line in a parallel line property, the corresponding angles will be equal. So ye bhi aapka kya ho jayega, 55 degree. Kya ho jayega, 55 degree. Now see this. Ab sirf triangle dekhiye, see the triangle. Angle A is given, angle D we have find right now, and what will be the angle E? Can we find? Yes, angle sum property of triangle. ठीक है, हम किससे निकाल सकते हैं इसको, एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ट्राइंगल. सो राइट डाउन व्हाट इज द आंसर. एंगल ए प्लस एंगल डी प्लस एंगल ई इज इक्वल टू व्हाट? इट विल बी इक्वल टू, इट विल बी इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. सो 65 प्लस 55, इट विल बी इक्वल टू हाउ मच? 120. सो ये कितना हो जाएगा? दिस विल बी 60 डिग्री. दिस विल बी 60 डिग्री. इट इज नॉट विजिबल. इट विल बी 60 डिग्री चिल्ड्रन. ओके, 60 degree. And now see this line, this line, this one, this is also an intersecting line. Ab isko bhul jao, aap leave it. Okay, now see the another line. Which one? This A, E and C. Ye yahan pe C pe cut kar raha hai aur E pe. So this line is also what? Ye bhi aapka kya hai? This is what? This is parallel line and this will be the transversal. Ab ye transversal ho gayi. Now this will be the transversal. Parallel line and this line is intersecting it at two distinct point. Ek E par aur ek C par. Do point pe intersect kar rahi hai. So this is a transversal line. So whatever angle will be this, it is same as this angle. Corresponding angle. Kya hoga ye? Corresponding angle. So ye kitna tha beta? This is how much? 60 degree. So this will also be 60 degree. Angle C kya ho jayega? 60 degree. So in this way you have to solve this question. Write down step by step. First write down and you can draw it separately also. After drawing this diagram, draw the separate diagram. Pehle D ko nikalne ke liye is diagram ko banao, and then for finding the value of C, draw this. And iske liye for angle E you have to use angle sum property of triangle. I hope it is clear to you children. Now your homework part is to complete all the even questions from question number 7 to the last question. Okay, and do question number 13, 14 and 15 in your book only by using pencil. Till then, children, take care and do practice. Okay.